Shortly after the November 2016 election of President Trump to be America's next president, a group of women who had tickets and booked hotel rooms to see Hillary Clinton's inauguration realized that they were going to have to walk away from the money. Instead, they planned an event called the Women's March on Washington to have all the disaffected women show up at Washington and raise hell and let everybody know that we were not happy with Trump's policies. Naturally, as a woman and as somebody who is clearly not happy with Trump's policies, this was my calling. So I made plans to attend. The Women's March on Washington was primarily organized on Facebook and very quickly outgrew the limitations of Facebook events and how often you can change them. Details, policies, and even sister marches sprung up on Facebook as well. Someone even created a knitted hat pattern for pink hats with kitty cat ears. Some people started crocheting them too, and they became known as the Pussy Hat Project. The rallying cry of the Women's March on Washington was, "Hear our voice." The Women's March on Washington was planned to be an inclusive march where everyone who supports women's rights are welcome. And I certainly did see a large cross-section of humanity there. In the end, turning the Women's March on Washington into a bit of a revitalization of second-wave feminism. While my state was holding its own Women's March on North Carolina in several different cities, I nonetheless felt the need to go to the Women's March on Washington, D.C. So I RSVP'd as part of the North Carolina contingent and quickly made plans to get myself up to Washington, D.C. by some form of transit. Luckily, the North Carolina contingent was very helpful with trip planning details and had even arranged several different buses to go to Washington, D.C., as well as packing Amtrak and Megabus, which were also headed to Washington, D.C. as part of their regular routes for that weekend anyway. And for those not able to travel by bus, train or megabus, there were also carpools that were arranged to go to Washington, D.C., as well as hotel shares and hostel shares and even Airbnb shares. Those who wished to attend but found themselves unable to afford transportation were given scholarships. Perhaps you remember this ad from the end of my previous videos.
See the safety pin? If your politics align with mine and you have either Bitcoin or Litecoin, donate below, because something cool is coming.
Thanks to your generous donations, we were able to send somebody. Don't worry. None of that money went to me. I was able to afford my own way. On the day of the march, I was able to walk from the place where I was staying over to the meeting point for the North Carolina contingent, as well as the meeting point for the Women's March on Washington. Walking in, I saw a lot of pink pussy hats. And also a lot of police and security. I easily found the North Carolina contingent exactly where they said they would be, with a great big sign.
No patriarchy, no fascist USA! No pussy grabbing, no patriarchy, no fascist USA!
As you can hear, the chants had already started at the metro station, far away from where the march was actually taking place. These chants are being done by an anti-fascist group. Waiting for the rest of the North Carolinians to show up was a great opportunity to see some really fantastic signs. I knew once I got into the main body of the march, I'd be stuck in a sea of humanity with a great view of the tops of people's heads and not much else.
Oh, very nice.
North Carolina wasn't the only state that showed up in force. New Mexico was also there in surprising numbers.
New Mexico!
New Mexico!
The flag! The big yellow flag! The prettiest one!
Yes! High five!
Okay, great.
We're going to
see you in a few minutes. All right.
Bye. Bye. I knew I wasn't going to be able to see many cool signs, but I hadn't counted on the giant sea of pink pussy hats that I would be surrounded by.
Yeah. Yeah, last night she's like, we gotta make a band. She said,
oh, there's no Mexico.
Pennsylvania, there are sashes.
From New Mexico.
I thought they were going to be here.
I'm going to put the scarf back on.
Look at all the corners. Look behind all of the stoplights. There's a giant yellow sign up in the air. Yeah, she can't see signs.
Okay. NARAL and Planned Parenthood and the anti-fascist organization you heard chanting earlier were giving out pre-printed signs, but even so, most people had made their own.
Come on. Come on.
You don't run the MIA?
I know.
They're Southwest, so we're across the way from us.
In case you're curious, this is what my sign looked like. Mine was double-sided with a different message on each side. As with any well-organized march, first aid healthcare workers were in abundance, as well as ushers who could help people find what they needed.
What it's called. Yeah, yeah. But yes, I hear you.
In front of the gardens, in front of Air and Space.
Okay.
So go if you guys want to go right up here.
Okay,
we're trying to make sure we get it here.
Actions such as attending marches are definitely not for the claustrophobic. This is the press of people, and we're not even at the march site yet.
Oh, there is lots of space in front of these gardens.
Hampered by traffic, only those of us who had arrived the day before were able to meet up for our section of the North Carolina contingent, and we had to leave the rest of North Carolina behind. Our North Carolina contingent hung out in front of the gardens across the street from Udvar Hazy, the Air and Space Museum.
Right just on exactly the opposite side of where we are right now, on this little...
Watch t-shirts.
Yeah, go.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Okay.
You dropped this.
Oh, thank you.
As with all marches, this one started with a rally to give the marchers time to assemble if they weren't already there or didn't believe in being on time. Oh look, there's me. I hadn't donned my pussy hat yet.
Two, seven?
Jill.
See, I don't always have bad hair.
She went to shop at every little place and look at t-shirts.
I'm going to make my entire footage publicly available.
And I did. My entire footage is publicly available on a very generously donated web space whose link can be found in the description of this video and will be posted at the end of the video so it does not distract from the march. And of course, the mainstream press was there, gave you a 10-second clip on the nightly news. Or perhaps a single picture of a really awesome sign to accompany a 250-word article in your newspaper. Good thing Jay for President attended this rally. The rally was started with an American Indian prayer song, translated into English, of course, for maximum accessibility. Did you hear that thunderous applause? That's the sound of a 500,000 people being gathered in one spot.
But the president is not America.
Currently hearing in the background is the man who has announced all the inaugurations for the past, well, I don't quite remember how long, but very long while, and was suddenly fired from that role by Trump.
I want you to say, hello, Charlie. Hello, everybody.
Hello.
To a nation and dignity of any and all of our people.
And then the speaker I was most excited to hear, America Ferrara.
Together, we rise. We rise too against bullying. And we teach our children not to bully. And that bullying is not leadership. We are the leaders our nation needs right now.
For security purposes, not that it was enforced, we were required to have clear backpacks and bags. And Michael Moore shouting out the phone number for the congressional switchboard so that we can all call and really make our voices heard. That is, if any of our senators would pick up the phone.
Okay. And what is that part? I don't know.
Congress's switchboard.
Okay, I got it.
So you call that number and then you say, "I want to speak to my representatives from wherever you're from," and they'll take it from there.
Congress.
Yes.
Excuse me. State representative. And your state senator on the other day. I'm telling you, these calls work. When they tried to get rid of the government,
it is.
Is
it?
Yeah.
Together, go home and fight in your community and in your school.
Before this next part airs, I think it's very important to let you all know that I do not agree with what the speaker is saying, nor did a large number of us, but you should hear it nonetheless.
As men, we must protect our women. We cannot allow cowards.
Did you hear that large groan and the lack of clapping? That's what happens when you try putting some benign paternalism or benign patriarchy in front of a bunch of women who know that we can handle things on our own, Kay thinks. It wasn't planned. It wasn't scripted. We didn't know it was coming. But the 500,000 women who were there collectively groaned. If you are a gentleman, and even if you don't care about American politics, please, please take note of the fact that women, by and large, don't want you to save us. We do not want a white knight. We want you to help us when we are the primary actors in our lives.
This poem is called My Mother Was a Freedom Fighter. She testifies a night song on the woolly back of a mammoth. Shadow boxing rivulets, a mother's cow falls to her feet. A fist in the pouch of a honey-hipped negra. Hail towering over the country, the farmers of plantations, the maids of motels, the mansions, the nurses of hospitals and camps, the shamans and huts walking to work in dawn fog with heretic hands. A chupacabra suffering in solos, or a black unicorn refugee panhandling at the border of an upside down dimension, beguiled by bars, bearing the burden of crimes of love, cold sweat, despair, almonds, denied a passport to mercy, a citadel of judgment. She was born in the bulwark of bordellos, brothels, poor women, least loved in pawn shops shaped as men, traversing the sins of them. Unyielding wind blows her back into dirt roads, waves dimly seen. My mother was a freedom fighter. Singed at the stakes or drowned at sea, she studied the way of water and gills. She is a mermaid. She is an archipelago of shanty towns. She is made of invention and necessity and found scraps, a bouquet of bloody music in her hands, cane of sugar, leaves of tobacco, a cluster of bananas, coffee beans, the husk of corn, a poppy seed, tea shrub, spikelet of wheat, rice flour, gold nuggets, diamonds and coltan. She is, my mother is an incantation bellowing from the fields and mines. Look for her in the ruins, at the funeral procession, drunk off palm wine, screaming in a traffic of arms, lonely. She is lonely but not alone. Remember her on the shores of Gori. She pitched yam and overseas in her baby's hair, chauffeuring the wrath of our stories. For when the files come home to roost, enduring the tides of whips, she wept by a mangrove and carved a seer from her lover's bones. Spitting on her thumb, she smeared shame from her children's cheek, blessed and esteemed. Lighted dreams born of zealous sires laid with her in a stretch of orchids, honeysuckles, daffodils, cots blooming or splayed on a cot during a conjugal visit, switchblade in her boot, straw hat sitting on her grave. She touches herself, moaning, pleasure pours gently on her in broad daylight. She was captured in the middle of a gunfight, muzzled by averted ears, smarmy smiles, and what befell their humanity. Remember, my mother was a freedom fighter, ever a drought. She gathers clouds on one accord and they rally above her, fermenting nature, her courage, she is beyond what named her courage. She arrived, quarreled by instinct, a petition for presence. It was a woman, it was a black woman, dark as night, dark as love. It was a woman who named neglect and maroon perishes. Hooting and hollering, she midwife revolutions in rainforests, Amazon, city sediments of her sorrow beseeching. Because of the eye of the storm within her, they called her magic. Nearly more, she was a freedom fighter, and she taught all of us how to fight. Love y'all.
My name is Paola Mendoza, and I am the artistic director of the Women's March on Washington. Rights activist, incredible.
this point, the crowd was getting antsy. The clock was looking like it was time to start the march. And as of yet, no newspaper had published a report telling us that the reason we weren't walking was because there was nowhere to go. We were packed shoulder to shoulder for the entire route of the march. The organizers hadn't told us yet either, and there was no cell phone service because there were so many of us.
Supposed to be marching right now, but we're late. It is no excuse. The audience is talking over Miss Monet because they want to march, and it is an hour overdue, and they are antsy and nobody has told them anything. And while that is no excuse to be rude, it is not because of who she is. It only has to do with what time of the day she is speaking.
Showing up as the dog is kind of mundane.
We will not remain hidden figures. We have an aim. We're complete human beings. And they cannot police us, so get off our areolas.
So there were rumors that we were not marching because there were too many of us here.
Yay.
And about an hour past the march time,
people were starting to come. Right behind us?
They just made an announcement that we are marching, but on a different route.
I think so.
There's a Niet sign. They were looking for one.
And so, after a few more programs.
Now they're giving us a minute to collect ourselves before we march, so that's going to be a while.
March,
I mean, I figure I should document all the feelings I'm having as well.
That's a what?
Oh, I heard fat.
No, he's not ready enough.
Either or both.
Songs that just go, so let's push forward.
It works.
My name is Melissa Mason, and I'm from Flint, Michigan. And please don't forget about us because we've not forgotten about you. So as you amazing women get out there in March, just know that Flint has been without clean water for 1,002 days today. We are poisoned. We are sick. We are pissed off. But we have not let that stop us. We have gone on the streets and the courts, and we stand together. We stand with all of you. And as you're out there fighting for the rights that we all deserve, like clean water and clean air, just remember, don't forget about us. Don't stand with you. Stop there, ladies. Have a great day.
Fidelity to love over hate, progress over regress, and inclusion over exclusion.
At this point, we are now a half an hour past the minute that they gave us to collect ourselves before we started marching, and we haven't moved anywhere. You'll see cell phones going up into the air as people are desperately trying to search for any sort of signal, social media, any news from anybody around so that we know why. Dear Lord, why? Why are we not walking? The frustration level amongst people is high. People are starting to crack very cynical jokes. And people are kind of not really wanting to march anymore. They're bummed out. They think that their energy has been wasted.
I stood with love. I stood with hope. I stood with sisters and brothers of all religions and all races and all genders and sexualities to exist. And we will emerge from the darkness and back in the brilliance of America. It honors the infinite worth of all of God's children. Take the hand of someone to your right.
They have told us we're marching. This is us marching.
Raise your hand high. We are the God's manifestation of hope and love and spiritual defiance. The God of hope and peace.
Mothers of America and all around the world. Oh, 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 oh
anyway.
And she tells me, Erica, what's going to happen? This is a woman who decided to leave the country that she was raised and born in through the desert with her children, the same woman who was in my house, and I accidentally opened the door to hide. It was taken. To you, I cannot tell you what's going to happen. But I can tell you this as well. You are not alone, and I want to also for us to tell every single person out there, every transgender woman who is in the detention center right now, you are not alone. To every black, brown, Muslim, LGBT child out there who right now is depressed and doesn't know what to do with their life because they don't know what's going to happen to them, you are not alone. Please, not be the norm in this country. Love will be the norm in this country. Thank you all.
I'm going to take a pause from this speech because it got some fame and notoriety to let you know that everybody around me had no idea who this speaker was at the time, because you can see how much attention we've been paying. In fact, the chatter that I cut out, but you can see in the full footage, discusses that we think she's Katy Perry. I will tell you, if you do not know who this speaker is, she is not Katy Perry.
Yes! I am outraged. Yes, I have thought an awful lot about blowing up the White House.
Taking back the White House, yes.
And because of the notoriety that this speech received, I need to also point out the audience's reaction to that little bomb dropping. Pun not intended. Did we cheer? No. No, we did not.
Are you with me? Please feel free to sing along. It'll keep you warm. It'll make me happy. Come on, girls! Do you believe in love? Because I got something to say about it.
For those of you who did not know, that speaker was Madonna, and the people you are looking at around you holding up signs did not appreciate the fact that Madonna was advancing her career at the sake of our cause. We did not like her verbal bomb drop at all. Ever ones to make lemonade out of lemons, we are, at least, actually moving now, and you will see that the Jumbotron appears, since we will have passed it, at which point people turn around, look at it, and realize, oh hey, that wasn't Katy Perry, that was Madonna. Madonna!
When it becomes painfully obvious that these speakers are reading from a script, because anybody who's actually there and using their powers of observation has realized that we've jammed the cells, and there is no cell phone signal for anybody to even so much as get a text through. But of course, scripts don't know that.
I am the product of my parents' perseverance and an embodiment of their values. Yes, hopefully 4 years. Yes. Today is the beginning of our journey as activists in the Trump era! We must commit to fighting policies and politicians at every level that threaten the existence of our families. Since your liberation is bound with mine, then let us work together!
what rhymes with united? Divided. You know what doesn't rhyme with united? Defeated. Where in God's green earth did the people united will never be defeated come from? The chant is, the people united, rhyming, will never be divided. Still rhyming.
We'll never be defeated. The people united will never be defeated. The people united will never be defeated.
I have an announcement of someone else that has been lost. She's a 92-year-old woman. Her name is Josie. And for our final song.
Audience poll. Who actually believes this is the final song and not the penultimate song? Drop it in the comments.
Everyone wants to come take us out with Ella.
I am a proud Ogallala Lakota Native American and African American woman. And we as indigenous women, we are all connected, every single one of us. So we would like to close you all out, all of us, with a prayer because we are the original inhabitants of this land. And so we want to thank you. We're going to sing a song. It's a women's warrior song.
Anyone know what comes after final song? Is this the final song? Because songs seem to not be stopping.
We sing the song, put your fist in the air, represent those women.
My dear relatives, before we say anything, we always thank the Creator first. My Lakota name is Bear Woman. My English name is Joanne Spotted Bear. And I do come from what you do. But furthermore, I want to sing a song. It's a prayer song.
I have just been informed that at the next street crossing, I'm going to encounter counter-protesters. I am psyched. I am so interested to hear what it is that people would take issue with out of the march, since the march has pretty much been incredibly reasonable, by my estimation. And with the faint strands of Love Trump's Hate, we know that we are close enough to the counter-protesters to see him and have a conversation. Just like that, the signs part, and the counter-protesters' signs come into view. There are three of them.
We choose love! 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 We choose love!
And how do the women of the march react to such counter-protesters? They simply chant, "We choose love," and do not engage further. And just like that, we're past the counter-protesters with no violence and no words exchanged by them. They simply held their signs and looked a little confused in the face of a bunch of women chanting, "We choose love," rather aggressively at them.
Hey, if you can hear this message, please meet Kim at the Smithsonian. That's scary. If you can hear this, please meet Kim at the Smithsonian American Indian Museum. Thank you.
The rest of the march was pretty much more of the same. Walking, holding signs, chanting things that sometimes rhyme, but often didn't, and continuing on forward.
So I made eye contact with the guy holding up the Black Lives Matter thugs sign, and he was looking really nervous and really scared and really uncertain. I think he did not expect that when he went low, that people would go high. He should have expected it. His mama raised him that way.
Oh,
this vibe in the streets after the Women's March is over feels very much like being in London after the Pride Parade was over. After Pride, like, absolutely very much.
I hope you enjoyed clips from my experience of the Women's March on Washington. These came from a greater body of work where I recorded the entire march on my GoPro camera. For the entirety of all of my footage, if you want to march along virtually, and warning, it's several hours long, you can click on the link provided on the screen or type the link shown into your web browser. Thank you for being a part of understanding this historic day.